everyone. Thanks for joining us today. So we'll tell you today about all the different kind of work permits that are available to come to Canada. It's very interesting that people just say, I want a work permit. Can you apply for a work permit for me so that I can come to Canada? So first I would like to tell you there are two kind of work permits. The one is the open work permit, and the second one are the work permits for foreign skilled workers. We'll discuss the first ones, open work permits first, because they are the easier ones. You can get open work permits to Canada if you are a dependent spouse of a foreign skilled worker or spouse of an international student in Canada. It is an easy way, because that is the way you file the application saying that you want to be reunited with your spouse in Canada. And under public policy and for reunification of family, these applications do well, and we do file a lot of them, because this is the easiest way to come to Canada and work for any employer you want. You're not restricted to work for a certain employer. Or you can get an open work permit if you're in Canada and get married to a Canadian and waiting to get permanent residency. So in the meanwhile, you can apply for an open work permit to stay in Canada and be economically viable. Or you can get an open work permit if you're a postgraduate student and applying after your studies to stay in Canada and work towards your immigration and pathway to immigration in Canada. Refugees get open work permit while their claims are being worked on and being processed for finalization, and they get a work permit and a SIN number and a health card so that they can live here while their applications are being processed. Now we'll talk about the difficult part, which is the work permits, which everybody keeps saying, can I get a work permit to come to Canada? I'm getting a job offer. Can you just give me a job offer so that I can come to Canada? So it is not that easy. You have to have a qualified employer in Canada who will be giving you an employment letter, employment offer, along with the approved LMIAs. So LMIA is the labor impact assessment, which you need to prove that you are not taking a job away from a Canadian to bring a foreign national to Canada. So it's a process where the employer has to do recruitment efforts, interview the Canadians, and see that they do not meet the requirement, and they're going to bring someone with special skills from outside Canada to do the job that is required in their company and be economically beneficial. So it's a process. So do not get into any kind of jargon where people are telling you that you just need an offer letter and it'll be done. You need the job offer letter, you need an approved LMIA, which is Labour Market Impact Assessment, to be processed along with your work permit application to come to Canada. Another way to come to Canada is, again, to have a job offer from a qualified employer under NAFTA, under GATS, which are international treaties, and you do not need an LMIA for that. You need a job offer and the right kind of category that you will be coming under. So it is, again, study a bit about work permits. Do not get into any fraudulent activity or somebody telling you that you just need a job offer to come to Canada. It's a very tricky situation, and you need to be very careful how it works. So you need to have an employer, and hopefully make sure that you have talked to the employer yourself, because employers usually like to talk to their foreign skilled workers when they're hiring them. They have the Skype call, interview, reference check. All that is done duly, just like if you were getting a job in your own country, where you go through the interview process, scanning, and another interview maybe, and face-to-face talking to the employer. So all that is a requirement. After that comes the work permit application. So make sure you go through it properly, and we are always here to guide you through the process when required. Thank you.